Welcome back. So today I am going to take up a very interesting topic called as zigzag connection of a three-phase transformer. So this reason for taking this topic are two reasons primarily for it. One is it is intellectually very stimulating, challenging, and you can learn a lot out of this on the abilities of the transformer to play with the phase shifts and the ratios, phase shifts in the transformation ratio as well as the scaling factor. The second reason is more practical or utility reason, which is that zigzag connection is actually used in practice. It's not a routinely used transformer, three-phase zigzag connection, but it is actually used to provide phase shifts which are similar to what you see in the star delta transformer or some other value of the phase angle shift also, and achieve some objectives like providing a grounding, a neutral, like for example, suppose you have a delta star delta transformer and the delta side does not have a neutral and you want a neutral there and yet you want to have a phase shift also, then you could use a kind of a zigzag connection, for example, which will provide the ground as well as provide the phase shift. And why do we need grounding? Grounding is required for safety reasons. Usually a delta side of winding of a three-phase transformer is usually a low voltage winding which is connected to a three-phase generator, which is usually star grounded. So the ground comes from the star side there, but in this particular case, suppose for some reason you didn't have the you had a delta winding but there was no generator which was star grounded, then you could go for a zigzag connection which will provide you the 30 degree phase shift yet while providing a ground there. And that 30 degree question may arise to you, okay, why do I need a 30 degree phase shift? That answer is more detailed, you will get it in a power system analysis kind of a course, but the intuition is quite simple. If you have in a system a loop, let us say a loop like this, and there is a transformer here which creates a 30 degree phase shift, then here also you should create any another alternate path also by symmetry, you should create similar phase shift, otherwise in absence of it, there would be circulating currents which will be flowing under no load condition, unnecessarily creating losses in the system. So once you start, once 30 degree shifts, for example, start getting introduced in the system, then you have to take care of it that whatever you do should not disturb the symmetry of it. Otherwise, in an interconnected system, you would have circulating currents which can be a problem. Those are the things that you learn a bit more in a power system analysis course in more detail. Here I am more interested in the device called three-phase transformer with a zigzag connection, which is built from a three winding transformer. And I am trying to figure out how beautifully you can create phase shift here using a zigzag connection. So I'm the more in the intellectually stimulating part of this particular problem. So let's take three winding transformers which we have studied in the previous lecture, that we have which I have marked as in the colors R, Y and B to indicate that the primary side of this transformer will be excited by red phase or A phase. This will be excited by Y or B phase, and this will be excited by the B phase or the B or C phase of it. So this is shown here. This primary winding is this one, this primary winding is here, and this primary winding is here. Now look at it carefully, that I have shown them in space at proper 120 degree phase shift. So the primary side VA voltage is this, primary side VB voltage is this, primary side VC voltage is this. The advantage of showing it in space in the appropriate way is that then you can do phasor addition geometrically along with your sketch of the winding. You will see that how I do that. Now look at the interesting zigzag connection, and it can now it will be clear to you why we are calling this as a zigzag connection. So it would be very clear to you that why we call it as a zigzag connection, because of the way it is oriented in the space here. This secondary of the see the voltage, if I connect it with a VA source here, consider that it's a star connection. So we have VAN, VBN, VCN connected on this side to the primary of this, this and this. So what it means is that the voltages which are induced in these two windings, which will also be in phase and a scaled replica of what is here, on what is the capital VA. So if the turns ratio is say small n is to 1, then this will be VA by n will come on winding 2 and VA by n will come on winding 3. I am assuming that both these windings are identical, otherwise again we have to account for that, but they will always be in phase with the voltage in the primary winding, which is the VA1. The one winding usually we call secondary, sometimes with the third winding we call tertiary. In this particular case, I am taking primary winding to be rated for 1000 volts and the winding 2 and winding 3 to be rated for 500 volts in this example. Just as a sake of illustration, I want to work a bit with numbers also. So now what I have done here is, this is connected to the R phase and is having A phase or R phase and is having a VAN voltage of 1000 volts. This is going to induce 1000 volts just like R phase, but 500 volts just like R phase, and this will also have 500 volts in just like your R phase voltage. So this winding is now 500 volts at an angle 0. This is the voltage of the winding here. Now what I am doing is, the dotted part of this R, say this one, this winding, for example winding 2, I take it to the undotted part of the Y phase, which is here, and then connect these two windings in series, and then bring this as small a or small r outside. So these two windings are series connected. These two windings are series connected, and the output which is coming from here is called as the A phase voltage on the secondary side. So this is basically R is nothing but A and Y is nothing but B. So the AB series connection, let me call it as A plus B series connection, is equivalent to the A phase on the secondary side of the three phase final transformer, is equivalent to this is what let me call this, for the avoid confusion, let me call this as B dash. So then B plus C will be equivalent to B dash, and C plus A will be equivalent to C dash. So this is the way I will equivalence it. So let's see, is that what I have done here. A plus B is equivalent to A dash, then B plus C, the Y phase and the blue yellow phase and the blue phase coming in series come as B dash, and then the RYB, so the blue phase or the C phase in series with the R phase or the A phase, C plus A come out as C dash. So because there is a series summation of the voltages, you can see that there will be a phase shift coming in the voltages which are coming on the secondary side, And this, from outside, it is just like any three-phase transformer. You don't realize that there are 9 windings which are sitting here. You actually think like there are 6 windings which are inside of it, if looked at as a black box. Now let's see what is this VA dash. So it is a phasor summation of this voltage and the phasor summation of this voltage. So now VR, I have drawn this VR here, and what is this voltage? This phasor actually is exactly this voltage from here, rise from here to the dotted terminal, is exactly in phase as the voltage rise from this to this dotted terminal, except that instead of being 1000 volts, it is going to be 500 volts. So therefore, this VR scaled replica of it, I have drawn here as 500 volts. And this 1000 volts scaled replica, I have drawn here as another 500 volts, and they are coming in the series. So now this angle here is, this angle here is with respect to this line is 60 degrees. So therefore you get to write this at 60 degrees, and this is 500, 500, so isosceles triangle. So these two angles are also same. So therefore they should also become 60 degrees, 60 degrees. In short, finally, it becomes an equilateral triangle. So therefore the resultant voltage will become 500. So 500 at an angle of, which is lagging the horizontal line by 60 degrees. So therefore 500 minus 60 volt. So this is how we did it geometrically. Now let's compute VB and VC also. Let's compute VB algebraically. So I use A as a standard notation to show a 120 degree rotation, which is can be written as e to the power j 2 pi by 3. And therefore, you can verify that 1 plus A plus A square is 0. 1 plus A plus A square is going to be 0. And this you can either sum it geometrically, or you can write a geometrical, you can expand each of them into rectangular coordinates and verify. You can verify it by geometry, or you can verify it as a geometric progression, sum of a geometric progressions, geometric series of consisting of only 3 terms and a ratio R of nothing but A. Anyway, you can verify that 1 plus A plus A square will be 0. So then, if you look at the voltage which is coming here as VB, the Y phase voltage, what is it? 120 degree lead followed by another 120 degree lead. So I can write it as 500 A square plus the C phase voltage. But the C phase voltage only leads the R phase by 120 degrees. So I can write it as 500 into A, which is just a rotation operator of 120 degree. And then take 500 common. So you will get 1 plus A square, A square plus A. But A square plus A is nothing but minus 1. So therefore, this VB voltage will turn out to be minus 500 volts. Or you can write it as 500 at an angle of either 180 degree or minus 180 degree. When you are here, you go by minus 180, you will come here. Or you go by plus 180 also, you will come the same place. So I use the notation because in three-phase systems, we want to make sure that the B phase voltage in the ABC notation, the B phase voltage lags the A phase by 120 degree. So we 60 degree minus 120 degree should be minus 180. So when I use this minus 1 as one angle minus 180, I can check that yes, the B phase voltage is of same magnitude as the A phase voltage, but lags the A phase voltage by 120 degrees. And then I leave it to you to see, show also that similarly the C phase voltage will be 500 and a lead of 120 degrees with respect to A phase voltage. So minus 60 plus 120 will turn out to be plus 60 degrees, and this is how I will get my ABC connection. So this series connections, one thing you will see is this series connections has not caused any problem with respect to the phase sequence and the balance when I go from the primary side to the secondary side. Only thing that it has done is a change in the transformation ratio, which is both a scaling of the voltage magnitude as well as the some change in the phase angle. So what is the transformation ratio? I have put it here as a question. Find the three phase transformation ratio for this transformer. So if I look at VRN primary by VRN secondary, then I have 1000 at an angle 0 divided by the secondary voltage here is 500 angle minus 60 degree. So therefore 500 angle minus 60 degree, or in other words, the scaling ratio is 2 angle 60 degrees. So this is the complex number. This transformation ratio is complex number. So therefore I have marked it with an arrow. Now VB, we have already worked out that VA, VB and VC are this. Now imagine that this is connected, this ABC on the secondary side are connected with a star grounded load. So this is what I am saying here. A three phase balanced resistive load is connected, balanced resistive load of 100 ohms, three phase balanced load of 100 ohms is applied to the Z side, the zigzag side, determine all secondary and primary side voltages and currents. So now we are going to see what are our voltages and currents. So because these are the three voltages on the secondary side, 500 VAN is 500 minus 60 degrees, VBN is 500 minus 180 degrees, and the third one is 500 angle 60 degree. And if you connect to this a star load of only 100 ohms each of the phases, then you can see that the current which will flow this is 500, and then there is a source here which is of 500 minus 60 degrees, and then you have a resistor here, and this resistor is of 100 ohms. So therefore this voltage divided by this 100 ohms is the current which is going to flow. So the current which will flow in this resistive circuit is 5 at an angle of minus 60 degree. Similarly, IB, the current IB in the ABC notation will be 5 angle minus 180 degree, and the third one will be 5 angle 60 degree. Okay, so the secondary side voltages are also known, secondary side currents are also known. Now second primary side voltages are anyway known to us. Now let us calculate the primary side currents, I capital A, I capital B and I capital C. I will first of all show you using a MMF balance for the three winding transformer here. Remember, the zigzag connection is basically a play of three winding transformers connected to three different phases. So now MMF balance here tells me that this N1 I1 should be equal to, if this is the current I1, this is the current I2 and this is the current I3, then MMF balance requires that N1 I1 should be equal to N2 I2 plus N3 I3, and because N1 is to N2 is to N3 is same as the corresponding V1 is to V2 is to V3. So instead, in this equation, N1 I1 equal to N2 I2 plus N3I3. I can also use for N1, I can use V1, for N2, I can use V2, and for N3, I can use V3. Or other way is to say that assume that there are 1000 turns on the primary side, 500 turns here and 500 turns here, whichever way you want to say. So now let us look at the MMF balance of the first transformer, three winding transformer one. So 1000 turns on the primary into IA should be equal to 500 turns into secondary plus what is the current which the winding 2 is carrying. This is the winding 2, this is carrying the small IA current, and what is the current this winding 3 is carrying? What is the current this winding 3 is carrying? This is the winding 3, this is the winding 3 connected to the C phase of the secondary. So therefore it is carrying current of IC. So therefore the equation that I get is 1000 times of I capital A should be equal to 500 times of IA plus IC on the secondary side of this zigzag connection. But we know that IA plus IC, IB plus IC is zero, being a balanced connection. So therefore IA plus IC can be written as minus of IB, and therefore it becomes the this 1000 IA becomes equal to minus 500 IB. But IB is nothing but minus 5 amperes. So therefore this will become simply 2500 amperes divided by 1000 sitting on the left hand side, and you will get that IA is nothing but 2.5 amperes. Now look at this another way. Treat your transformation ratio N is a complex number. So normally when it's a single phase transformer and when we want to take the currents from the secondary side to the primary side, we just divide it by the turns ratio N. But in case of when there is a phase shift, we actually need to be careful. We need to, and I'm illustrating it here, that we need to do the division by N star or N conjugate of N. So what happens now? If this is understanding this principle that you can actually just the voltage scale by the ratio of N and the current scale by the inverse of N square. So if you divide this IA, which is 5 minus 60, by N square, which is N was, what was my N? 2 angle 60, and I divide it by 2 angle 60 star, then you will immediately see that again you get the same current as 2.5. So therefore another way of, one way could be, this is a much more insightful way of doing it, but a quick way of doing the same thing is to just take the IA and divide it by N star, and you will immediately get 2.5 ampere. Now similarly, let's take the current in the prime. Let's try to calculate the current in the winding here. So when you want to find out this capital B is in the ABC, the capital B is actually your Y phase. So some ABC notation and RYB notation, the B gets, usage of B gets a bit mixed. I'm sorry about it. Nothing can be done about that. But this is actually the Y phase, the second phase. In the ABC, this is indicates the Y phase, which is what we are looking now in the second three winding transformer. So the 1000 IB should be equal to 500 into, now one of these is connected also to, so the one of these is also connected to the corresponding B phase, is connected to the B phase here. So I get 500 IB. And the third winding, the third winding here is actually connected to in the secondary side to the A phase. So therefore, I will have to write it as 500 IB plus IA. But again, using the fact that IA plus IB plus IC is 0, this is minus 500 IC. But knowing that IC is 5 angle 60, this will become minus 2500 angle 60. And therefore, I can write as 1 angle minus 180 degree. And so I can write it as 60 minus 180 as minus 120. And then scaling this 2500 by 1000, I'll get IB as 2.5 angle minus 120 degree. So now again, you can see the nice symmetry which is coming in the ABC. IA is 2.5 angle 0. IB is 2.5 angle minus 120 degree. So automatically, I mean, I leave it to you to show that follows that IC by symmetry will be 2.5 angle 120 degrees. So now look at your VA, VB and VC. So the VA is 1000 angle 0. VB is 1000 angle minus 120 degree. And VC is 1000 angle plus 120 degree. And therefore, you can see that a unity power factor load on the secondary side has actually become a unity power factor load on the primary side. And this is very, very important aspect that you should note. Currents at the unity power factor for both primary and secondary windings, in spite of the phase shift in the YZ connection, still remain at unity power factor. So if you look at the power in the primary side, this will be 1000 into 2.5 volts, that is 2500 volts per phase watts. This watts is per phase. And if you look at the secondary side, then this since this phase is here connected with a 100 ohm resistance to neutral, so therefore I can directly write this as 500 square by R, V square by R, which is again turns out to be 2500 volts per phase. So phase wise also you can see the power balance on the primary side and the secondary side. A resistive node has reflected as a resistive load from the secondary, it has reflected as a resistive load on the primary, and the power balance is also there. Now one more thing that you expect is power balance V1 I1 star. This is from our previous lecture. V1 I1 star should be equal to V2 I2 star plus V3 I3 star for each of these three winding transformers. So let's check the power balance for the first three winding transformer. So V1 is nothing but VA, which is 1000 volts. The current which is flowing in the winding 1 is 2.5 amperes. So therefore, V1 I1 star is nothing but 2500 plus J0 is the complex power which is flowing in it. Now let's look at the, so we have got V1 I1 star. Now let's look at V2 I2 star and V3 I3 star. So V2 is nothing but scaled replica of the V1 voltage, which is halved in this example, so it becomes 500 volts. And the winding 2 is carrying the secondary side A phase current. So therefore, it is 5 minus angle 60 degree. So therefore, the V2 I2 star becomes 2500 plus angle 60 degrees. Now, the winding 3, the winding 3 also carries just the scaled replica, which is 500 volts in phase with this winding 1. But it carries a current which is corresponding to IC, which is flowing through it. So therefore, I can write V3 as 500 volts and I3 as IC, which is 5 angle 60 degree. So therefore, V3 I3 star becomes 2500 at minus 60 degrees. So when I do V2 I2 star plus V3 I3 star, I will get 2500 into in the brackets 1 angle 60 degree plus one angle minus 60 degree, but if you take one angle 60 degree and sum it with one minus angle minus 60 degree, this creates an equilateral triangle with the resultant sum on the x-axis, which is one angle zero. So therefore 2500 watts. So therefore the conclusion is 2500 watts entered this and moved as summation of 2500 watts if through winding 2 and winding 3. But notice that reactive power exists in winding 2 and winding 3. The winding 2 is also having a reactive power and winding 3 is also having a reactive power. The superposition, however, in the superposition, it is cancelled in the winding 1. So this is an interesting subtlety that you should capture. Similarly, we can show the power balance for the other two phases. So one last point that I want to make before I close this lecture is that this is my VAN by capital VAN by small VAN is the complex terms ratio N. Then the capital IAN by capital by small IAN is 1 by N square. This is how the star delta three phase to three phase transformation ratios work. What if the N is a complex number, then this will be 1 by N star. You keep following as you do more and more courses in power engineering like power systems and so on. Keep checking about, keep an eye on the validity of this equation. You will find that this is how it works out. So therefore, when I look at, if I have a secondary load of, on the secondary, if I have connected a complex impedance load, let's say star grounded of ZL, then VAN small VAN by small IAN is ZN, by small IAN when it is ZL, when I reflect it on the primary side, I want to see what is V capital AN by I capital AN, then V capital AN can be written as N times V small AN, and I capital AN can be written as small IAN by N star. And therefore, when this N star goes here, N star, it becomes just the square of the magnitude of N and into small VAN by small IAN. But that is nothing but ZN. So hence, VAN by IAN becomes mod of N square times ZL. That is hence like a single phase transformer, when the impedance is referred from secondary to primary, then impedance is just scaled by magnitude of N square, which is always a real number. So therefore, there is a, if you have like 1 plus J3 as the impedance, it will not become something, it will still have, if you look, when you scale, if it is 1 plus J3, for example, it will, if suppose the scaling factor is 10, and so this may become 100 plus J300, but this angle here is whatever is here, this ratio is going to be in the real to imaginary part. The same ratio will hold through here. So a lagging load will never become a leading load when it shifts from primary to secondary. It will be exactly, the power factor will remain the same. So I think with this we will close this lecture. I hope you enjoyed the subtleties of series connections of voltages and what play they can do in a three-phase transformer connection. Thank you.